Now let's focus on whether f of x equals x cubed is even, odd, or neither. So we say that a function is even if graphically it reflects across the y-axis. So in other words, if you were to flip your graph across the y-axis, would you get your original graph back? And so if we were to do that, we would see that, and again, this is kind of a rough sketch, so it's not perfect, but if we flip across the y-axis, we see what's in this first quadrant here would show up in the second quadrant here, and what's in this third quadrant here would show up in the fourth quadrant here. And notice what I have drawn in red, that reflection across the y-axis, is not the same as my original function, which is in blue. And so we would say that this function is not even. So then we would go on to test to see whether it is odd. For determining if we're odd, there's a couple ways to look at this, but for an odd function, we're saying that we're reflected through the origin, which is this physical point here at 0, 0. And to reflect through the origin, you can think of it as a reflection across the y-axis and the x-axis. So if you start with your graph of f of x equals x cubed here in blue, and you reflect it across the y-axis, which has already been done by this dashed line here in red, and then take that graph and reflect it across the x-axis as well, we'll see that we actually overlap our original function. And so that is by definition what it means to be odd. And so f of x equals x cubed is an odd function. So that's one way to look at it. Another way to look at an odd function is as a rotation through the origin. So again, the origin is 0, 0, and if we were to take our original function and rotate it through the origin 180 degrees, would we end up with our original function? And when we talk about rotating 180 degrees, I always think of that as like a rotation of two quadrants, so from where you started. So this would be about one quadrant, and then going one more would pull me to this third quadrant here. So I started in the first quadrant, I end up in the third quadrant, and I'd actually overlap this bottom half of my function. And then if I did the same thing for the bottom half of my function, and I went, let's say, 90 degrees and then another 90, so 180, that would pull me back up to that first quadrant, and I would overlap my graph. And so in the end, I would actually get my graph back when I rotated 180 degrees through the origin. So that's another way to explain that our function is, in fact, odd.